I just heard something that blew my mind away. Looking ahead to Monday, March 14th, or 3.14, also known as National Pi Day, basically pi, that constant value used in math that represents the ratio of a circumference of a circle to its diameter, which is about 3.14. It also just so happens to be Albert Einstein's birthday, so how fitting. Classrooms around the world celebrating Pi Day, combining fun and education for ways to do that at home or maybe in your classroom. I'm joined by Hannah Wampler with Sylvan Learning Center, and I was just, we were talking about 3.14. I'm like, golly, my kids could, you know, say it forever, and you said...
Someone actually has tried to recite it and has taken up to 10 hours to do so. It's impossible to actually do the entirety of pi.
Right.
It breaks computers down just trying, but someone was blindfolded and attempted to do 10 hours.
That's mind-boggling.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have several activities that families or schools can do. Let's talk about circle art. What are we going to do?
Yeah, so as far as pi goes, a lot of times when we think of Pi Day, a lot of folks really want to think about bakery treats. So we're not talking about that. We're going to be looking at instead, you know, a bakery treat with maybe something funny on it, like the letter of a Greek alphabet. And that is representational of that pi, right? So when we're talking about Pi Day, we can talk about things that are circular. So
yes,
we can rope in dessert,
okay? Absolutely.
But we also can rope in polka dots, okay? And you can do this with different shapes and sizes, but you can start really early those conversations about numbers, math, things that are really valuable. Now, I used a shortcut. I used label stickers because nobody has time to cut those out. But when you're talking to kids and they're putting those stickers on pieces of paper, the biggest point of value is to start talking about how no matter how small the circle, no matter how large the circle, whether it's a frisbee or a ball or even a pie or even the globe, they can measure that circle or better understand it with math. So it makes it more interesting.
Yeah.
You're starting those conversations at a really early age in an approachable and fun way.
Yeah, makes it fun. Like you said, okay, what project is this?
So this is for when you're getting into those numbers, like you mentioned, with your kids. Memorizing that sequence is really intimidating.
Yes.
So what we've done here is created a letter chain, or a number chain, pardon me, that corresponds to different colors. So when we look here, we've got purple for 3, 1 for pink, and 4, do you know, after 3.14?
No, I've heard
5.
I will help
you out. Okay, it's 3.14, 1 again. So you're going to pull out another color of 1.
I got you.
And staple it onto the chain. So you can continue that pattern for as long as you'd like.
That's awesome.
I have a fellow math teacher friend who said she did the whole chain around her classroom.
That's
so
fun. It's something to do. Okay, we have 30 seconds left. What's this last one?
So this one is creating kind of your own language with pi. You can write out a word that also corresponds to those number sequences. So if you have 3, you'll pick a 3-letter word. And try and create sentences with pi.
Fun. These are all things you can do at home, maybe in your student's classroom. So thank you for coming
And
then you can always make a pie. And maybe
you can
do
always
some
make a pie.
Math, maybe do some fractions and talk about, I don't know. Anyway, Hannah Wampler with Sylvan Learning Center. If you'd like more information, we've linked you to Sylvan Learning on our website, fox59.com, so you can get all the information there and do these at home or at school. Good to see you.
Yeah.